welcome to Off-Broadway Boutique presents Positively Lynn. Here we are again at the Plaza Hotel. I knew we'd come back. I'm getting used to this lifestyle and I'm loving every minute of it. We have more to show you today. The Italian Welfare League, we're doing a luncheon, we're doing a fashion show. You're gonna love every minute and we have surprise guests for you. We may even meet Ivana Trump. And Heloise may surprise us. You just never know what's going to happen on these days. So come on with me. Artie, my prince in shining armor, thank you so much. So come on up to the Plaza Hotel and join us for a fantastic show, one of our many. Okay, here we go. Come on, come on. Here we are in the Grand Baroque Room of the Plaza at the Italian Welfare League, and just mingling, I met this charming man whose name is Larry, who's an omelet king. I can't even get his last name, so Larry, hi Larry.
Thank you. Hi, how are you?
What's your last name, Larry?
DeCrisanti.
I love it. How did you become the omelet king?
Oh, I don't know. It happened quite a few years ago. I came to New York to do other things, but one thing led to another. I found that I was in the catering business all of a sudden. And a gentleman that was doing it taught me how to do it. And from there on, I was...
Is that what you specialize in?
Yes, that's one of my specialties.
Yes.
But I do other things as well, yes.
Yes, uh-huh. Now, where do you live? Is it the Upper West Side? Where mostly?
Midtown Manhattan.
Yes.
On the East Side. But I travel to do this parties anywhere. I go to Florida, I go to California, I go to Connecticut a great deal, and New Jersey, and places like that.
You're terrific. Now, I want to know, are you single?
Yes, I am. Now I am.
Oh, you got rid of whoever it was,
well,
right? Or she got rid of you?
Probably both.
Well, you're a handsome guy and an eligible guy and a cook who can make wonderful omelets. I mean, you can't go wrong with
very
that. What's your favorite omelet?
Oh, I don't know. I guess ratatouille, I would say, but I like them all.
Tell me some of the omelets that you specialize in.
Cheese and bacon and ham and vegetable. Spinach, things like that.
So in other words, if I were having a party, you set up right in front and you do
yes,
the omelet?
I have very portable stoves and I go anywhere with them and I set them up anywhere you like. And I serve, you know, from whatever you custom ordered.
Tell me, Larry, how did you become involved with the Italian Welfare League?
Well, through a friend of mine, Vera Cugini, who's my neighbor at the shore, and she got me involved, but I even involved a lot of other charities as well.
You know, Vera,
one of my favorites.
Vera is a client of ours, a friend of ours, and that's how we got to do the show today.
That's wonderful.
Yes,
very nice.
It's a lot of fun. It's lovely, and it's a wonderful organization.
Yes.
And it's nice.
Right.
Larry, keep making omelets.
Thank you.
Watch us on TV.
I will.
We're delighted to have you.
I'm delighted to be here.
Thanks so much.
Most gracious.
Thank you so much. Here I am at the Grand Ballroom of the Plaza Hotel, and I have the most provocative, compelling man sitting next to me, Bob Grant. Bob Grant, welcome. I'm delighted to have you.
Well, it's very, very nice to be here. Thank you.
Bob Grant, they're honoring you today. That's lovely. Why are they honoring you?
I don't know.
I hear you speak so sensationally. You're so provocative. How long have you been on radio?
I hate to tell you how long, since 1948.
You don't look that old, Bob. Whatever you're doing, keep doing it. You're
well,
handsome.
I was still in school when I started, and that's what became my career, even though I didn't intend it to be my career. It just worked out that way. Everybody said, this is what you ought to do, and...
And you're very good at it. The people who love you really love you, and the people who don't like you really don't like you. Is that true?
I think so. But when they take the ratings, they don't ask whether you like the person. They just ask who you listen to.
And your ratings are so high.
Well, that's the whole thing. Without the ratings, nobody stays up.
Well, you were always this outspoken as a child, or did it come with confidence and with a radio talk show?
Well, what people find it difficult to understand is I was paid to give opinions. Off the air, I don't give too many opinions. I don't say too much. But on the air, I say a great deal.
That's great. That's wonderful. This is really the new way, right? You have to say what you feel.
Well, years ago, of course, radio and television was a very bland. They were bland media. And now, I guess, reflecting the general society, everybody's so outspoken. It's not just me. It seems to be everybody.
So, in other words, when you were very unique years and years ago, it's not so unique now, but yeah. You are unique. No, you are unique.
Oh, well, no, there's thousands and thousands out there just like me. You know, I'm just one of many.
But there are so many people imitating you, but there's only one Bob Grant.
Well, what did Shakespeare say? Imitation was the sincerest form of flattery. So I guess I've been flattered many times.
That's true. Now, what would you like to see happen? You know, we're up for a mayoral election, and Giuliani's wife, Donna, is going to be here. Tell me, what would you like to see happen in the city? A positive thing.
Well, I think it would be a positive thing if Rudy Giuliani would win the election.
You do think so?
I think it would also be a positive thing if Herman Badillo became the comptroller. I think these two gentlemen are strong. I think they have good, solid ideas. And I do believe that Rudy Giuliani has within him the potential to be a great mayor. Not just a good mayor, but a great mayor. I've known him for a long time, and I've seen him grow. I campaigned with him in 1989, and he was unsure of himself until we got close to the end of the campaign. But the Rudy Giuliani of 1993 is sure of himself, he's confident, and if the election is honest, he will win on November 2nd.
Very interesting. What a plug for him. Now, tell me, when you say if it's honest, what does that mean, if it's honest?
Well, what concerns me are the irregularities that have already been reported in the primary on September 14th. The fact that people are coming into polling places who have been voting already several times. It's a terrible thing to say, and we don't like to think of it that way, but there are a lot of reasons to be fretful. As a matter of fact, I talked to Rudy Giuliani just yesterday. I had him on my program, and he is aware of this potential. The key, of course, would be many, many federal overseers overseeing the election.
That's a very interesting thing. I would never have thought of that, really. That's so amazing. Do you know Donna, his wife? Because I'm going to interview her today, and I hear she's a lovely, sweet lady. Donna, Rudy's wife.
Yes, I know Donna. Of course, she's a colleague, having been a news anchor over at Channel 11. And I've met her, well, through Rudy. Rudy introduced us, actually, back in 1989.
Now, Bob, if I could wave a wand and you could do anything you wanted to do, what would you like to do as far as business and maybe personal? Tell me that, too.
Well, I'll tell you what I'd like to do. I would like to have a coast-to-coast television program, and just 1 hour in length. This 4 hours on the radio is fatiguing, it's tiring, it's enervating. And what in heaven's name possessed me to sign a new 7-year contract, which I just did the other day?
Please tell everybody what channel you're on and when you're on.
All right, WABC Radio 77 on your AM radio dial. And it's every day, Monday through Friday, from 3 until 7. 4 unnecessary hours.
You'd rather do it 1 hour a week on television. I love what I'm doing, so, you know, I'm in the ladies' retail business. How I ever got into this television, I don't know, but I love it. It's so exciting.
Well, let me say this. I have only met you a few minutes ago, and I've only been interviewed by you a short time, but you are a natural. You are just a natural at this. You are effervescent. You didn't hesitate every time you had to ask me a question. You knew what you wanted to say. You are mentally alert, and you are a very charming lady.
Coming from you, I am so flattered. Thank you. I thank you for this interview, but I have one more question. I want to know how, after all these years, you stay looking as well as you do. What have you done to yourself?
I have done nothing yet, although my good friend Dr. Robert Catani says he could make me even look younger. I think really it's the fact that my mother's side of the family all seem to be blessed with, I don't know, youthful appearance or whatever you want to call it. And if you saw my mother, who's 90 years old, you'd never dream she was that age.
Bob Brandt, I thank you so much. Lots of good luck. Stay with us. We'll be right back. I have a very special lady sitting next to me who is the oldest member of the Italian Welfare League. Antionette, Giaimo, welcome.
Thank you.
Okay, look into the camera because they want to see that beautiful face of yours.
Well,
you're fine. You're wonderful.
Good. Thank you.
Tell me, how did you start in this, and how did you become Woman of the Year?
Well, that I can't answer. They just chose me.
Who chose you?
The board members.
Now, how did you become involved with the Italian Welfare League to begin with?
Yes, that was quite a story. I met a customs official one day, and he said the Italians were being mistreated at the docks. At that time, most people came in by boat,
right?
You see? And so I decided to join an organization that was taking care of immigrants that were coming in. And this was the organization, the Italian Welfare League.
Isn't that
interesting?
It started
with Mrs. Pereira.
Is that who it started with?
Yes.
How many members were there when you just started?
We had 35 at the time, and they were all well-to-do ladies that wanted to do something for their people.
I think that's such a wonderful thing. Now it's changed. The Italians coming in today are probably better educated. Coming by airplane and better educated than maybe we are.
Yes,
so tell me, what is the organization doing now?
Now we're helping social service workers, diabetes, most everything. Italian migration also, connected with Father Tomasi from Staten Island. But the most important thing is that we gave $15,000 to St. John's University to start an Italian chair, inasmuch as St. John's University has the largest percentage of Italians in their college.
Isn't that interesting?
That's
wonderful.
Interesting to me.
Now, wait a minute. You've been a member so long. You look so lovely and so young, I must say.
I'm not telling you my age.
I will not ask you your age because it's very unimportant. You just look so wonderful.
40 years, to be exact.
Do you come to all these luncheons?
No, not all of them. I've eliminated a few.
Right.
I have this luncheon, NIAF, and the Italian businessmen's. Well, I do those things.
The Italian businessmen's, I like that.
Yeah, and there's the Italian Historical Society that I helped, and the reconstruction in on Welfare Island.
Oh, that's
right.
Well, we thank you. It's been a delight, and enjoy the luncheon.
I enjoyed it. Good. Doing what I did, what I have done the past years.
Thank you
and
for
thank
joining
you.
Us. Thank you. Well, you know we would never leave you unless we completed a fashion show. We did not want to let you hang. So here we are again with our fashion show and a continuation. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy this fall show because a luncheon is not a luncheon without a fashion show. Now can we have some music? Maestro, please. Let's get on with the show. Oh my, isn't this lovely? This is Knit again from Italy. Beautiful Al Norell outfit, tight leggings, knit sweater, cowl neck. Cindy, I can see that's for skiing, for dinner, for going to the theater. You know, today we've kind of much more casual than we've been in a long time, but it's still no excuse not to look lovely no matter where you're going or what you're doing. It's the total look. Warm and cozy, right, Cindy? Thank you. Oh my, is this gorgeous or is this beautiful? Anybody can wear this. This is lovely. Charlene, white cowl neck, sweater, a vest. Again, look at the total look. The earrings, the white felt hat, light shoes, and the stirrup pants, which are removable if you don't care for stirrups. By the way, this is as lovely with a boot as it is with a high heel shoe. Comfortable, Charlene? Good, thank you. The next outfit you're going to see, Corey in total purple, beautiful. We did so well with the sweater Corey is wearing that we reordered it this year. It is the most comfortable sweater, her rib shawl and the red earrings. Corey, you look beautiful in that. Now Pat, her twin, will come out. By the way, ladies, these sweaters are one size fits most. Nothing fits everybody. One size fits most. But what's interesting is they come in small, medium, and large, and the only difference is the length. They're comfortable, they're easy, they're great. See, Pat, I see you know a lot of people in the audience, right? We call Pat the mayoress of 72nd Street, of West 72nd Street. Excuse me? Okay. They're going to switch capes and switch things so you can see how lovely the clothes look. Purple and red, isn't that lovely? And it would be just as pretty with black over it. Notice one is wearing high heels and the other one's wearing boots. It would be lovely with a flat boot. Dinner, theater, casualness, weekend away, Atlantic City, you name it, you can wear this. You look lovely, girls. Thank you. What have we got here? Janine, how coquettish. Lace is big, knits are big, ruffles. Is she adorable or is she adorable? Janine, you must know a lot of people in the audience. You're getting the biggest reaction of all. What can I tell you? Again, remember, lengths, anything goes. Do you remember your grandmother's wardrobe? Well, it's coming back. It's great. And the hat is 35 ways you can wear that hat. One hat. The sweater is separate and the skirt is separate. Just look at the work. It's marvelous, isn't it? Thanks so much, Janine. Isn't it wonderful to see women get dressed up? I don't know about you, but when I look at myself in the morning, I'm not too thrilled. Pierre, I didn't even see you. Black suede fringe skirt, black fringe cape. Lots of fringe. The suede skirt is divine. The shawl with the fringe on it is super. And notice the hat with the velvet band around it. Suede feels good. The fringe has piano fringe on it. The shawl has piano fringe on it. Thank you, Pierre. You know, Pierre has done many of our TV shows, and let me tell you a little about Pierre. She's skinny as a rail. She's a size maybe 6. She's got the shoulders of a football player, so everything looks good on her. Big shoulders and a tiny girl. Thank you. Oh, Nina, here's something everybody has to have if you have a good body, is a cat suit. The cat suit is a basic. If I die and come back again, which I'm sure I won't, I will never be able to wear a cat suit again unless I wear something over it. But it's fun to see her in it. The suede jacket that she's wearing is a jacket we make in our shop in any color you want. Turquoise, red, black, caramel, green. It's a super jacket and her body is super. But then again, she's young and the hell with her, right? Her cowboy hat with the beads on it is fun. It's a fun look. What we try to do when we do a fashion show, and we've done many of them at this hotel, we love working at this hotel, is we give you a little bit of everything, just a taste of everything. Nina, that's delicious. Thank you very much. Now everybody's talking Southwestern, and look what we have here. We have an Indian blanket coat. And this is lovely. What they've done is they've taken strips and put it all over the coat. Isn't that a fun coat? And there's no closing. If you just put one collar inside the other, it stays closed. Cindy, when you go skiing, that's perfect for après ski. Oh, delicious and cozy. And do you remember the Orlon blankets? That's what this coat is made out of, Orlon blanket with fringe. Lovely color. The poly blanket coat can be washed, and it feels to touch it and feel it. You can use it as a blanket, you can use it as a coat, and it's lovely on you. Charlene, thank you. Oh my, this is pure elegance and pure class. Adrienne Lynn Dell does this shawl, gray, knit with gray fox, available in all black, available in all brown, and many other color combinations. Over the suit of the year, Pat, let's see that suit. Beautiful, thank you. Lovely tweed jacket and skirt. Notice the dark hose and the dark shoes with the charcoal hat with a pin from Lori Ray, who runs the jewelry department in our shop. You look smashing, my dear. Very elegant for next year's luncheon at the Italian Welfare League. Here is a cape that we make ourselves in our own workroom. Corey, that is so lovely. And the collar comes down. For daytime, for evening, over suits. You know, sometimes you cannot get a coat over a suit. So we decided to do this long cape coat, and it's just delicious. This is something we make in our own workrooms, and we're very proud of. And to touch it and feel how soft it is, you would love it. Corey, that's lovely. Thank you. We also do it in bright red and white, and we do it in different lengths. Did you drop something, my darling?
Thank you.
Okay. Oh, look at Janine. Is she the cutest thing? Now, here is an outfit you won't believe. We sell from size 6 to size 16. And what we do is the 16 wears a skirt or pants with it. Is she the cutest thing in the world? Oh, Janine, that's lovely on you. It's beautiful with a skirt. She doesn't need a skirt. And it's beautiful with a pair of trousers. It's double wool knit. Hold your hands out. Good girl. Like a bird. Is she cute or is she cute? And look at that little French hat she's wearing with it. That's sensational. Terrific. That's a pro all the way. What can I tell you? Oh my, here is the most beautiful, beautiful top that we make. Off-Broadway's plaid organza jacket. Pierre is wearing it with trousers. It's available in black organza, in white organza, and it's beautiful. And you can see she looks beautiful in it, doesn't she? And this is for any size, from 6 to 16. We just started manufacturing this and selling it to other stores. And when you wear it in black, you can wear a short silk skirt and a black silk top with it. It's beautiful in black over a completely black silk outfit. And it's lovely the way Pierre is wearing it. It moves, it flows, it's lovely. You have to have a little attitude and a little style. Just remember, you never get a second chance to make a first impression. Oh my, is this lovely, ladies? This is done by a friend of mine, Yolanda, who's a Polish lady who does the most gorgeous prints you've ever seen. And one of the reasons she does the prints is because she said everything was so gray in Poland that she wants to do prints and bright things. That is gorgeous. And of course, Nina's wearing it over a catsuit, but believe me, It is just as beautiful over an outfit like I'm wearing, a silk top and a silk pair of pants. Nina, that's lovely. Thank you so much. I truly feel like Queen of the Hill. Here I am at a spectacular spot in front of the Plaza Hotel, in front of the fountains, in front of Bergdorf Goodman, in front of FAO Schwartz, and right next to Fifth Avenue, with taxis and limousines. What a way to live, I must say. We've had such a great show, but now I want to tell you a little secret that I don't know if I should be telling you. A very dear friend of mine lost her mother, and she wanted to have her ashes thrown someplace, buried someplace, and everybody said, well, it should be over water. And her daughter said, my mother was not a sailor, and you know where her ashes are? Right in this park, right in front of this fountain, because she was not a sailor, she was a shopper. And you know what? If I had my ashes, I absolutely would want them here too. What an exciting place to be buried if you're going to be buried. So thank you so much for joining us. And you know what? We have to come back next week. There's so much we've done, we couldn't finish it this week. So thank you so much for joining us, and tell a friend, watch us on Tuesday mornings at 11 a.m. and Thursday evenings at 8:30 p.m. on Channel 17. Mwah! Have a great day.
You got to accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative, and latch on to the affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. In-Between. You got to spread joy up to the maximum, bring gloom down to the minimum. Have faith or pandemonium, liable to walk upon the scene. You got to accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative, and latch on to the affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. In-Between. You got to spread joy up to the maximum, bring gloom down to the minimum. Have faith or pandemonium, liable to walk upon the scene. You got to accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative, and latch on to the affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. In-Between. You got to spread joy up to the maximum, bring gloom down.